It's Fran in the Fran Lab 3.0. While we were in the move and stuff, I got a new one plane display. You know how I love the IEE one plane displays, all their displays. I've done so many videos on them, all the indicators and projection displays that they've made, and this one is kind of unusual because it's apparently a demonstrator for the one plane displays that's loaded with all kinds of sort of kind of odd and interesting things. It's not your typical counting, you know, 0 to 1 with a decimal point type display. It's interesting too that one plane displays, they never really disappeared. In fact, there's been a reemergence of one plane displays. I've got a nightlight, which I'm going to be breaking apart in a future video, which when I got it, it displayed a drawing of planets and galaxies and stuff on the ceiling. But the LED in there, it's like a very high ultraviolet white LED, super bright. And over the course of many years, probably like 3 or 4 years, it just gradually faded away. Now it's just pure white, so the film in there is just completely transparent. But I thought it'd be cool to try and hack that and put in a little frame of 16mm film to kind of bring back the projector aspect of it. And even like a pen, little novelty things like this pen came from DigiKey. This is the kind of thing that they would give away at trade shows. In fact, this was submitted to me by a viewer who had like a collection of trade show swag. But this has got a little projector on it. I'll show you on the desk here. All right, so yeah, see, little projection. Yeah, there you go. All right. Yeah, it works pretty well. It's just, you know, just a simple lens and a probably some, you know, regular watch batteries in there stacked up and a little switch. You know, so I guess close up it's like, oh, look, it's a pen light. But no, look, it's an advertisement for DigiKey. So it's the one plane display has always been very useful and handy. So this is it. One plane readout, Industrial Electronic Engineers Inc., Van Nuys, California. This is a 6.3 volt model. So yeah, and it has a little sticker on it, demo unit, sample images. The dealer that I bought this from, they sent me this scanned copy of the cover of the IEE catalog, The Wonderful World of IEE Readouts, and the short form catalog. But yeah. All kinds of things, including like a, you know, lots of space stuff, you know. And this one, it's got no diffuser on it, but if we look inside here, yeah. So there's the lenses in there, and it's kind of hard to see, but they're in this concave sort of assembly because they're all aiming at a center point in the front where the diffuser would be. You know, I have so many of these displays that have no diffuser on the front. People that would use the one-plane displays, maybe a lot of times they would, you know, group them inside of an assembly and they'd have just one big, you know, diffuser bezel across the, you know, the thing or whatever. But it's got this mask, kind of goes in the front, and I cut a piece of diffuser that should work really well. I'm just going to tape that in place here. That should work. It's got 12 lamps in it, and they're all used, or at least they're all wired up. See, there's the brown and black wire is going to be the common. Okay, let's see how this goes. All right. Ooh, test. All right, test. Green. I wonder if that. It's not projecting anything. I guess again, if this diffuser were more, had a finer grain to it, I guess that would light up green. So I guess if I put them two together, testing green test. Probably. Okay. Might not be lamps in all these. Fail! Yeah, I need a better diffuser. Fail! Oh! I put two together. Oh, fail voltage. Yeah, voltage. Fail voltage. Again, that green light. Where was that green one? Yeah. Okay. Fail. Okay. Ooh. Pass. Yeah, definitely need a much more, like, darker diffuser. It looks a little off-center there. But that was one of the problems with the one-plane displays is that the light coming through the mask with whatever it's going to say, if it's not exactly on center, you get this where you see the hot spot on the right side and the P is just barely lit. That is a common problem with these one-plane displays because the masks are so small. I mean, we're talking microfilm sized. That doesn't do anything either. So some of these lamps might be out. Four! IEE Series 10. Yeah, there we go. There's the ad. Eight! Ooh, okay, there's the red. So yeah, that would, I don't know, I guess I've had more, yeah, okay. Five! Okay, so let me see if I can put a piece of vellum on here. All right. Just like everything else, I can't find my good vellum. I'm just going to use some regular tracing paper. See, that's the five. I don't want to, okay. Yeah, okay, well, choose that. Well, that's much better. Okay. I'm going to try this all over again here. Let's see. Five. Yep, series 10. Yeah, the bulb's blown out. There's the eight. Oh yeah, okay. So you could go red eight. Yeah. I don't know, it seems surprisingly dim. Yeah. I'm running at full 6 volts. It's not very bright at all. Yeah. Red eight. Four. Fail. There we go. So red, and then so you could animate it like that. Fail. That's pretty cool. And then pass. Get the green here. There's the green. That green is really dim. Could be bad contacts in there, or it could be that the dim green, it could be that some of these bulbs are blown out and they might have replaced it with a higher voltage bulb. It could be like an 18 volt bulb or a 16 volt bulb, and so it could be that. So I'm gonna take the back off. I'm gonna see if I can find these Lance, I can't find my little mini flange bulbs, but I can swap around some bulbs in here just to see the ones that aren't working. So from the back, I'm gonna see which ones actually are not working right now. So, okay. Okay, that's the green one. Looks like a green LED. It's kind of weird. it's not an LED. It's a lamp, but it has that T1¾ size. That's the green lamp. Okay, so that's working. That's the red one. That's working. Yeah, that's about, oh, that looks like it's a number. It's just these last two. So I'm gonna pull the back off and see if there are even bulbs in there. Because you have one hand to pull that away, one hand to pull that away, and you need the third hand to actually pull the block out. So it's a three-handed job. Oh wow. Well, those are not flange bulbs at all. Oh wow. Those are not mini flange bulbs. I can see the bank of lenses in there. Yep. I can see the green filter on that one. Yeah, you can see all the lenses in there. We've got the light going the opposite direction. You can see the red and the green gels. None of them look blown out. In fact, all these bulbs look brand new. One weird thing though, these sockets are not all the same. See, some of them are longer than others. I guess they do that for the concave shape. See, some of them are standing up a little higher than the others. But yeah, it was these two. Maybe it's just bad contacts, maybe? Yeah, oxidation maybe? Alright. I'm gonna put it back in and see if I can. Okay. Try it again here. Okay. Let's see what these are. Oh! There's one. That was an M. Okay. M. There somewhere. Oh. 60. Okay. All of a sudden, that's not. I got another one's not working. 4. Was there a 4 before? I don't remember seeing the 4. It's a pass. Voltage is now very dim. 8. There's the red. Still got one that's not working. Okay, so it's working there. I think all I did was flip the block over. Lots of oxidation. All right, so basically, I flipped the block around and we saw the other three, but yeah, there's these sockets are just really corroded. So yeah, that's all it was. But yeah, okay. At least we got to see all the all the symbols. That's it. Okay. Another one plane display. Hope you found it cool. I've got other stuff to show you, actually lots, so we'll be back pretty soon. So thanks to the patrons for sticking out the move. 4 months was a long time. I'm gonna be doing a push this year to try and regain like 200 patrons that I lost over the move. So over this year I can get back a couple hundred patrons and, you know, get the lab kind of funding wise to where it was, you know, before the eviction, for the most recent eviction back in September. So we'll get there. And also I got more films. I found a bunch more films that I wanted to transfer, so I'm going to be setting that up and getting the films up in the next few months. Lots going on. I'll see you real soon. Bye! In the lab. That's where I work. Berserk in my lab, it's where I work. I'm Fran.